Hi, this is TapCat. Welcome back to my ongoing Dark Souls series. This is part 36 of my attempt to beat the game despite being, well, pretty awful at playing action games. I have given it some thought, and I believe what I'd like to do is work on getting my Balder side sword into a fire weapon. Well, there's a bunch of scimitars. I thought about this one, or even the Lucerne, but we already have the lightning halberd when we want a really, you know, heavy hitter. And I do like the Balder side sword, so this will kind of give me an excuse to play with it. We already have Quelaag's Fury Sword, so it isn't like I'm in desperate need of a fire weapon. The main reason to do this from my perspective is if for some reason I didn't have a bunch of humanity, then that becomes not nearly as good. I meant to do this. Yes. Okay. So now that that's done, we can reinforce it again. And this time we're using green titanite that we have just a million of. We get to the part where we need red chunks. That's okay. Don't really have any other, you know, purpose for them to fulfill. I need to ascend it again, don't I? No. I thought it went to plus 10. Is there an ember that I haven't found yet? Is that what's going on? Well, I don't get to reinforce it anymore.
What was that about? Don't be coming on.
Okay. That's strange. I'm a little weirded out by that. Where is the sword, by the way? Huh. Well, let's give it a try. I'm thinking there should be some bone wheel skeletons out here. I see one off in the distance. And I see these skulls. Can I trigger them and kind of... Yep. Kind of know I won't have to bother with that anymore. Yeah, it's easy to trigger them. The trick is you want to make sure you get well away before they blow, if you do. So this is the way we came before. We came in here. There was a black knight guarding that corridor. We've already killed some of the bone wheels, but look at that. There's like three right there. If I could... So I'd love to pull these like one at a time, like that. Okay. It's not bad. I don't know if it's amazing. I'm stuck. There we go. So that's one of the three down. So, actually... I keep forgetting that I don't want to lock on. If you're going to try to roll away from somebody, I definitely don't think being locked on in advance is your best bet. So that's two down. Now the good news is all we have to do is take care of this third guy. Whoa! Okay. That sucks because he's going to do that. Yep. And we are just chasing each other all around. Let's see if I can kill him quick. Ah! That is annoying. Well, see, that was a shot I could not afford to take. Like I said, I have no Estus. I desperately need to kill him without taking any more damage. Pinwheel is a relatively easy boss. That much is true. However, trying to take him with just straight up no health, that's probably pushing my luck. So this tells me there was a path to get to that, which I missed. And I think for now at least, I'm going to leave that. I've really been trying hard to get 100% of all the items, but I am not sure that I'm going to go back through there. I might do that later. Okay, I'm pretty sure that this is the path. I have only one great combustion left. Okay, you know what I do have? It's called the Divine Blessing. And this is not a bad time to use that. I could try... Okay, first of all, I don't think this is the situation where I want to be using a weapon that I'm not really confident in. Let me take the Fury Sword. Actually, you know what? Let's just hit him really, really hard with that. I'm trying to remember. I think he uses either a magic attack or fire. It's one of the two. I'm going to guess magic, so we'll take the Grass Crest Shield. Oh, doggone it. What I meant to do was look at this. Yeah, okay, that is the one that's good against magic. So I have that. I don't think I need different armor, and I don't have anything that's going to make me particularly resistant to magic. So... I think we're good. Oh, I know what I meant to do. Duh. I was going to equip my pyromancy glove. So, didn't mean to do that for a second. The Great Chaos Fireball is good, but I really want a quick hit to start. So we'll start with this and then we'll maybe try pyromancy. Okay. Yeah, you have to drop down. Crap, that's going to hurt me more, too. Let me get that ready. I could easily die just coming into the fight this hurt and know, well, I have the Divine Blessing. It is creepy in here. Okay. Are you him? Okay. Haha. That's not bad. The rite of kindling is mine. Whew. Okay. You know, it's kind of cool though, because I mentioned before in the last segment, he is a pretty easy boss. So, not really having any Estus and not having half of my health, it definitely created a little bit more tension than what I would have felt, you know, otherwise. Mask of the Father. I don't remember all these. What does that do? Has a special ability, right? One of the three masks of the Pinwheel, the necromancer who stole the power of the Grave Lord and reigns over the catacombs. This mask, belonging to the Valiant Father, slightly raises equipment load. Yeah. Okay. I probably won't be using that. So, I know there's one that helps boost your endurance recovery. What is that, like a cleaver? Bone saw? Is this a thing? Oh, there's a ladder here. Alright, there's nothing else in here, right? It's just all these books and stuff. You know, just the other day I watched a video. There's a guy who did a series called Dark Souls Prepare to Cry, and he does all these lore videos, and I just happened to see Pinwheel the other day, and man, it's a sad story about how he was trying to bring his, I think it's his son, but it's his child and his wife back from the dead, and it went wrong, and so his body is like a combination of all three, and he's trying to like fix it, and that's why he has all those books and stuff. I'm not doing it justice. Just if you're not familiar with his channel, search for Dark Souls Prepare to Cry. I'm sure you'll find it. He's gotten a ton of views, and I know he's very well respected, at least I believe he is, in general in the Dark Souls community. Said there's a shortcut ahead, so I wanted to see what in fact is over here. Okay, just a shiny. And I believe that just doubles back on the path that we took to get to Pinwheel. I already forgot his name. No respect for poor Pinwheel, huh? I should just be able to come down here. So obviously, what I want is to get to a bonfire, right? You know what I'm going to need to do? We need the skull lantern. There we go. So when you hold it out, you get light. So as I remember, there's a bonfire really early in Tomb of the Giants, like basically as soon as you get there. These things, by the way, can be really slippery. I'm not positive if I was on that side of it, the left, that I wouldn't just slip off and die. Well, welcome to the Tomb of the Giants. This is the place that kind of made me tire of Dark Souls on my first playthrough. And I quit. It wasn't just here. That's overstating it a bit. The Duke's Archives I actually went into and struggled really badly as well. And it was a combination of things that started to frustrate me with the game. And then this was just kind of the straw that broke my back. I see. So there's a ladder down below somewhere. We will worry about that another time. But at any rate, yeah, this kind of represented my breaking point. Okay. Yep, we just gotta go. Really nerve-wracking, you know, doing that. Okay, there is a shiny behind this guy. Let me try this. Yeah. This is such a good pyromancy spell. It takes up two slots, which is why I didn't use it earlier in the game. You know, I just didn't really have enough slots to spare. But, really awesome. Oh, crap. Oh, son of a... Shoot. I'm in trouble. Okay. Yep. Well, I'm going to start over at the bonfire now. See, I didn't remember that there were two. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to work my way back there, and then you will rejoin me when that happens. Okay, sorry I didn't talk for a second there. I kind of was so intent on getting my humanity back and all that that, I kind of lost sight of what I needed to do. So I'm getting shot at now. I remember there was another one of these guys. There's one in the distance. Okay, am I going to get hit by any more arrows? It doesn't seem like it. So, okay. I don't quite know how that other one attacked me then. It's not like I came super deep. It must be this guy, huh? So let me switch back to my fireball. Okay. Now, I could swear... Okay, we're not there yet. But I could swear that we're not far from... Can I go off this way? Oh, I just missed being able to get that shiny. Oh, there's patches. Okay. Isn't the bonfire somewhere close to him? Yes. Okay, that's what we wanted. Here's a ladder. Okay. So at least once you manage this, you know, you're not in such horrible shape. Now, before we start exploring the Tomb of the Giants in earnest, there's actually, well, let me do a couple of things. Number one, I want more fireballs. We're going to get rid of regular combustion, and we're going to swap it for a great fireball. So that gives me 8, you know, spells with actual range. And they all hit pretty hard. And then, believe it or not, I'm going to warp back to Firelink Shrine. And I think what I'm going to do, because you've watched me do this multiple times, I'm actually going to go back to Firelink Shrine and ultimately the Asylum. And I'm not going to fight anything there, but I'm going to give the crow in that nest one of my skull lanterns. And he's going to give me the fog ring. Then I'll warp back here. And I'll have you rejoin me then, okay? So for you, it'll be 1 second. For me, you know, I'm going to take a little bit longer. And then I'll show you the fog ring and what it does, all right? Welcome back. I picked up the fog ring as planned. So let me show you what it is and get it equipped. I don't want to give up the wolf ring here. So we're going to have to give up the Chloranthe, I'm afraid. And here we go. The Ring of Fog reduces presence to prevent discovery. Those who befriend Alvina are given this mysterious ring. It resembles a pearl with its robust, pure white fog. The ring camouflages its wearer's presence, helping to prevent detection. There actually is a way to get this early in the game if you join the Forest Covenant, the Forest Hunters, rather. The problem is that you have to be good at PvP, especially these days. I am not, and I don't have any interest in pursuing that. So, yeah, that's a thing. Wow, my hair is showing through my hood. But this is what it does. It turns you transparent. So, we are going to go up. Now, I'm actually going to retrace my steps initially because there are things over this way that we did not find, okay, or do. It was more important to me in the short term to just get to the freaking bonfire. You know what I just realized is that I probably should level before I do this. Since I ultimately do want to do that, I don't think it makes a lot of sense to risk this. I'm not going to kindle this bonfire. There's another one deeper into the Tomb of Giants that I might. And I'm sure, yeah, we can only go up one level, so it's not like it's, you know, the be-all, end-all. But, there you go. Okay. So, yeah. Let's let's get back up to where the bad guys are. Obviously, everything will have reset now. But I'm not even going to make it far enough for that to matter, am I? We're coming down here. So now, this area in particular is one of the reasons that I wanted my fireballs. Now, there are a bunch of skeletons down there. The ring is helping us and not get detected. And I didn't mean to do that. I actually want to just come down. Oh my gosh. Well, this is a bug in the game. This is the second spot I found that. What happens is when you slide down a ladder, for some reason, you just go straight to the floor and you fall to what? I don't know, the core of the earth or something. And you die. And so the one is in Undead Burg. And so that's the only one I knew about up until now. But yay, I just found a second one. That is exciting. Thank you, Dark Souls. You know, I love this game. I truly do. I'm actually having a much better time playing it, now than I did the first time. And I actually liked it a lot for a long time in that playthrough as well. But just from a pure technical standpoint, like the engine and stuff, they didn't do as good a job as they could have. Some of the things that they want you to do, they didn't design the game to handle, like things like going down a ladder automatically instead of step by step. If you're going to build that in, okay. I actually didn't mean to do that, but it worked out really well. Okay. Yep, I'm pulling a bunch. Okay. Wow, this isn't actually hurting them as much as I thought it would. I have got to back up and heal. And then... okay, that's one down. That'll help a lot. Okay, this is a problem. I need pyromancy, and I need it, like, right now. So, I had actually lost aggro on some of these guys. I'm gonna die. Yeah. So, I didn't do that nearly as well as I could have. But I also feel like I don't have the right weapon for this fight. That I want fire. And, well, I don't have my humanity. So, the Fury Sword won't be as good as it would normally be. I'll try the Balder Side Sword. I accidentally tapped the red circle, and there goes all my humanity. 13 I was carrying at the time. Okay, well, there's that. You know, rather than reset that right now, since I'm going into what is a very dangerous area, let's not burn 10 of the humanity that I'm carrying and then hope for the best. Let's go in there, because I have, look, I have nothing to lose now, right? So if I die, I die. We'll just try and do a better job. What I'd really like to do... is try to lure these guys. Now, I know you can jump across there. I just don't know if I can jump across, especially without switching to 30 frames a second. So, let me get out Great Fireball. Oh, okay, I can't switch. It like delayed on me there. Crap. Okay, I didn't really want another fireball. Okay. Oh my god, this is doing like no damage at all. So I need my glove. I need great combustion. I need a roll. I'm gonna die. Unless I do this really well and quickly. Okay, I wasted one. But I killed them. This is not, you know, doing it pretty. How many times have I said I'm not good at action games? It's not just me saying it. It's very hard for me when I get in those situations where like I have to switch between different things and, you know, react really quickly. Let me go to the Chaos Fireball because I'm more confident that will kill with one shot. So that's another one down. You can see another one. See his legs highlighted by the shiny, and then you see the eyes over there. There's a bunch of these guys down here. And when you don't have the Ring of Fog, it's so hard because you aggro all of them. Like, right from the beginning. Okay, I think even this thing will kill him. In fact, you know what? I totally forgot. I gotta get rid of this piece of crap. I'm sure pretty much anything I have will be better. Let me just take the Uchi. Let's not get fancy, you know? Like, let's just try and take care of business. I just want to get what's in here and get out. And I don't think we have a lot of these guys left. Okay, I'll use combustion on him. I think he's the last one. I fought really poorly my first time, or maybe this first two times in here. Oh, it's another one of these guys. A smith like Andre. So, unfortunately, it's not the large fire ember. It's the large divine ember. So, I'm still stuck at +5 for my Baldur side sword. And I have to say, man, that was just, like, totally worthless in here. Okay, but we did get everything out of there. So, that's good. Now, I don't know if there's anything around here. It doesn't look like it. I don't know where that stupid archer is. There's something up here. If I can get to it. Okay, hold on. Wow, this is awkward. So let me switch to Great Fireball. Or a Chaos if I have. Okay, so I'm going to let the arrow hit me. Then, oh, I forgot to switch to the glove. So do the same thing again, and then I'll get my shield up as quick as I can. Okay. I need to see, am I going to die if I step off? Yes. But not if I come over here. And now I'll try another fireball. And that's him taken care of. This place is so nerve-wracking, seriously. It is funny, though. I don't know, man. It grated on my nerves so badly in my first playthrough because of the dark. I don't know. Like, right now, it's a challenge, but I just don't have that same feeling that I did then, for whatever reason. Okay, I'm going to equip this in case I need it. And obviously there's another one up there, so I'm just going to walk forward slowly, use my fireball. Now, can I get up to that thing? I mean, there has to be a way. Okay, here we go. I assume that's it. I just got to be careful. I don't want to, like, start running because I think it's safe. Okay. Is this how you just climb up? Is that the deal? I think so. Okay, so let's do this. I'm pretty sure I just can roll. Oh, okay. I rolled a little more than I wanted to. Let me try that again. Okay, perfect. I got three Eyes of Death that I will, well, never use. And then over here is this. Wasn't there another one, though? Yes. Okay. And then, please tell me I don't die if I step off of here. Okay. But I am hurt. So, you know what? Since we've cleaned this out, I think what I'm going to do, in the interest of time, I'm just going to homeward bone. We'll go back to the bonfire, because I'm not coming back this way, so I don't care about resetting, guys. And this is a good place to end it for this time. So when we come back, we will explore the rest of Tomb of the Giants. There's a fair amount we haven't seen yet. And yeah, we'll do that. But that's all for now. Thanks for watching. I hope we see you next time.